Минулого тижня уряд Канади проголосив ще одне домовлення про співпрацю з Україною. Міністр імміграції Канади Марко Мендичіно розкаже про нову програму мобільності, яка відкриває нові можливості праці та імміграції, та увійде в дію, як тільки закінчаться обмеження, пов'язані з пандемією COVID-19.
Well, Minister Marco Mendicino, welcome to the Contact Ukrainian Television program. Here we have a really nice announcement about cooperation between Canada and Ukraine, which specifically outlines the possibilities of movement between our two countries. So, Minister, welcome to our show, and could you describe what this program is all about, please?
Well, thank you very much for having me, and I was very excited to announce a new working group between Canada and Ukraine, which will result in additional mobility and strengthen ties between our two great countries. This will see that there is greater opportunities, I think, to exchange work experience, to facilitate greater mobility when it comes to the processing of travel documents, and just generally to broaden cooperation on other migration related matters. And what we hope what will come from all of this is not only increased opportunities for young people, but just really strengthening the bonds between Canada and Ukraine. I know something that we have been both working very hard on. I also want to say a big thank you to Ambassador Shevchenko. He and I have had many, many good conversations. He's a great guy, and I just want to thank him because we could not have achieved this important milestone without him and his team's efforts. So a really important landmark for Canada and the Ukraine.
Minister, in the press release that came along with this announcement, there's reference to immigration levels plan, which was tabled in October of last year. This is for 21 and 23. Can you tell us a little bit what those immigration levels are? Because our community somehow feels that immigrants from Ukraine to here are sort of being left out as far as the numbers are concerned for national immigration to Canada.
Well, the Ukrainian-Canadian diaspora at 1.3 million people has a very strong presence here in Canada, and that's in large part because of Canada's immigration policies. And when I tabled this plan, it was in keeping with the spirit of growing the diversity of our country, but also ensuring that we are bringing in the workers and the international students that we need to propel our economy going forward. Now, the truth is that we're still in the pandemic and we have to do it in a way that is safe. And that's why we have taken very, very strong and strict measures at the border. But that immigration will continue to help us respond to COVID-19, as well as propel our long-term prosperity going forward. And I think this is something that certainly Ukrainian Canadians, or, you know, in my case, the son of an immigrant Italian family that came here after the Second World War, we understand that, you know, we understand that immigrants have a lot to contribute. One in three businesses in Canada is owned by an immigrant. And in turn, they employ hundreds of thousands of Canadians. And this is good for the economy. And this is what our plan will deliver.
On a different level, but still relating to immigration, we had on our show on Contact the critic for immigration, Rachel Dancho, mentioning that there seems to be a slowdown or a slow process in relation to family reunification. How do you feel about a comment like that? Like, what would be the slowdown if there is one?
Well, there's no doubt that this has been a challenging time for families. But what I will say is that since the onset of the pandemic, that our government has reunited tens of thousands of families by creating the corridors and the pathways to bring loved ones together so that they can help overcome this very challenging moment. In addition to that, we prioritized nearly 50,000 spousal sponsorship applications at the end of last year. And going forward, we have relaunched the parent and grandparent sponsorship program. This year, we will welcome 30,000 applicants. That is a record level for any one year. And when you take a look at all of these initiatives and you put them together, it demonstrates that we believe very firmly in reuniting families, and that our government understands the importance of bringing loved ones together, not only to get over this difficult moment, but also because they help support the economy. And when you have a strong family unit that can be together, you know, you can go to work, you can ensure that your kids go to school, all very important things for the economy as well. And so we'll keep doing that work.
Mr. Minister Mendicino, you mentioned in your comments youth, and youth is also referenced in the press release. Could you get a little bit more into the youth aspect of the mobility announcement that you've just made?
Well, as I said, what we are going to do next after having made this announcement is work to launch a youth mobility agreement between Canada and the Ukraine. And this is just another corridor of opportunity for young people who wish to acquire more skills and more experience as they set about their careers. And the one thing that we have seen over the past number of decades is that the global economy is increasingly connected. So the more experience you can acquire abroad, the more likely you are to be able to pursue a career that will allow you to achieve your full potential. And we think through this youth mobility agreement that we will be able to accomplish that goal. It will be good for young Canadians. It'll also be good for young Ukrainians who may wish to come and sample some of the great Canadian experience. And we know that from many different initiatives that Canada is a top destination of choice for aspiring newcomers. So again, a really important step and something that I think that the Canadian-Ukrainian community should be proud of.
The minister, there have been security concerns about the fact that visa applications are being, processed out of house, specifically by VFS Global. And considering the international or global issues that relate to relationships with China, what do you think about this farming out the processing of visas? How will it affect, or how does it affect, security and confidentiality of the information that's being processed in this situation?
Well, the first thing I want to assure you and your viewers is that we take the privacy of Canadians very seriously. And every single one of our clients, that is those individuals who are applying to come to Canada as a visitor or as a permanent resident, is stored on a database that is at a server that is here in Canada. We want to assure everybody that all of Canada's privacy laws are adhered to. The incident that you referred to dates back to 2015, and it has been rectified. And certainly going forward, we will ensure that we are working with all of our partners to protect Canadians' privacy.
Okay, very good, Minister. I understand that you're a very, very busy man. Tell us, I see you're working from home. Like, who schedules all your work? How does it work at your end here as a minister?
Well, you can see I am here in my basement office. I've got a wife and two daughters, and they get all of the natural light, and I get the basement office. So the universe is exactly as it should be here in my home. But I mean, look, it has been a really challenging time for Canadians, and my focus and my schedule and all of the minutes of every day that I'm working is really to try and support them. And in the context of immigration, what we are trying to do and what I believe we're succeeding at doing is creating these opportunities to reunite loved ones, to keep the lifelines that we need to bring in the workers so that we can keep our economy going, so that Canadians get access to affordable food, get access to health supplies, get access to the fuel that we need. And going forward, to put an immigration plan into effect that will help us get over this pandemic and chart out that course for long-term prosperity, something that I am very passionate about as a son of an immigrant, and being able to contribute in public life this way is very important. So that's what I'm here in my small space, but we're doing important work, and it's obviously a real honor to be able to contribute.
Okay, Minister Mendicino, thank you very, very much. And I'm sure that our community will be very happy with this, with the operation and the implementation of this new Canada-Ukraine Mobility Working Group that you've just announced. So thank you very much, and good luck with all your work.
Thank you very much. Slava Ukraini.
Член канадського парламенту з округи Etobicoke Center Іван Бейкер висловив своє задоволення з приводу цієї нової програми мобільності між Канадою та Україною.
Добрий день. Мене звати Іван Бейкер, я депутат до федерального парламенту тут в Etobicoke Center. Канада і Україна діляться вже давно сильними відносинами. Я вважаю, що сьогодні ці відносини були зміцнені оголошенням Canada-Ukraine Mobility Working Group. Canada-Ukraine Mobility Working Group був встановлений канадськими і українськими урядами, щоб знайти і встановити можливості, щоб українці могли легше приїжджати в Канаду, раз COVID-19 закінчиться. Через це партнерство, цей Working Group, перш за все, Канада і Україна будуть працювати, щоб встановити так званий Youth Mobility Agreement, щоб дозволити, щоб молоді люди з України могли легше приїжджати в Канаду і навпаки, раз COVID-19 закінчиться. Я думаю, для тих з нас, котрі вже давно працюють, щоб українці могли легше приїжджати в Канаду, щоб зміцнити наші бізнесові відносини, наші культурні відносини, це дуже сильна новина на короткий термін і на довгий термін.